A new 5G security flaw hits the news. Surveillance through FaceTime and Facebook stops at nothing to get your data. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse and this is ThreatWire for February 5th, 2019, your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Last month, thanks to our patrons, I started rendering the video RSS file at a much smaller file size to help with data caps. It's still at the same 1080p format, so if you see any kind of compatibility issues, make sure to let me know. The link for that video RSS is down in the video description below on YouTube, so definitely check it out if you're interested in downloading the video files. And real quick, I would like to give a special shout out to my newest Patreon supporters this week, including Micah, Jamie, Patrick, Don, and Edsel. And if you are interested in supporting ThreatWire and unlocking access to a slew of awesome perks, hit up patreon.com/threatwire. And now, on to the news. A flaw was recently discovered in the new 5G protocol that would allow a third party to use IMSI catcher-like devices to snoop on the data on this new carrier protocol. Four researchers over at Syntef Digital Norway, ETH Zurich, Switzerland, and Technique University Berlin, Germany discovered the vulnerability, which affects not only 5G, but is also backwards compatible with 3 and 4G protocols as well. It affects the authentication and key agreement, which is AKA for short, and that's the technique between your phone and a cellular network that allows them to communicate securely. AKA is supposed to negotiate and establish a key exchange between the phone and the carrier to encrypt the link. 5G AKA is supposed to thwart IMSI catchers, but the vulnerability opens up a potential entry point for newer devices to spy. Data about a user's activity, such as the numbers of texts or calls received and sent, could be used by an attacker to profile a victim. And if you take your phone away from the signal of a newer IMSI catcher, well, the moment that you come back within its vicinity, it can pick up where it stopped and continue that tracking. So this could be used to track political figures or officials and targeted attacks, not only to see amount of calls, but also to track physical location between fake base stations. The researchers responsively disclosed their findings to 3GPP, which is the third generation partnership project, and GSMA, and the parties are taking steps to remedy this situation before the end of 2019, when we will surely see 5G start up in the public. Last week, a major bug surfaced by 9to5Mac, detailing how iPhone users could use FaceTime group chats to snoop on the audio from other phones without their knowledge. All someone would have to do is call another user using FaceTime, and they would immediately hear the audio from the receiver's phone before they even accepted or rejected the call. The ringer rings as normal, so the receiver would know someone was calling, but they would not be able to tell if you could hear their audio before they actually picked up. Many iPhone users took to social media expressing their concerns about the ease of use of this vulnerability. Put simply, you would just have to start a FaceTime video call to an iPhone contact, and then when it's dialing, you swipe up from the bottom and you tap Add Person. You add your own phone number to the Add Person screen, and then you start a group FaceTime call with yourself and the audio of the contact. Now, to make matters a lot worse, this flaw could also be used to snoop on the video feed of the user. To do this, all a user would have to do is press the power button while on the lock screen, which also would send their video to the caller. And according to BuzzFeed News, pressing volume down did very similar to this situation. Now, while the underlying cause was not specified, security researchers think that bad logic coding of the group FaceTime processes could be the problem. After this news broke, it was discovered that a 14-year-old boy found this flaw over a week prior to the news article while playing Fortnite with his friends, and he just wanted to chat with them. The boy stumbled upon the bug on January 19th while trying to initiate that group FaceTime call. His mother reported this problem to Apple through a series of posts and emails, but to no avail. It appears that Apple knew, or they should have known, about the problem for a week before actually getting around to fixing it. Now, while they did respond to one of her reports on January 23rd, it was not clear to the mother that they were actually going to fix it. Apple disabled the group FaceTime Lifetime feature on January 29th, and it has been listed as temporarily unavailable on their system status page, as you can see here. Before they disabled that feature altogether, the best option was just to disable FaceTime in the iOS settings, and unfortunately, that was the only option. Apple is now experiencing legal concerns related to this bug. They have been sued by a Houston-based lawyer who claims someone eavesdropped on an important conversation, and New York Attorney General Letitia James has also initiated a formal investigation into the bug. A software patch will be made available to users this week in iOS 12.1.4, and to update, you simply go to your Settings app, go to General, and Software Update. Well, Facebook is not out of the security headlines yet. No surprise. Facebook uses an Apple program called the Developer Enterprise Program to create and manage apps that aren't found in the Apple App Store, but are available for download. This is usually used by companies to create internal apps used for internal capabilities. Facebook used the Developer Enterprise Program to create and distribute an application to the masses, though, that allows them to obtain user data while paying that user only $20 a month. Now, since Apple has pretty strict privacy rules for their App Store, this is a loophole that Facebook was able to take advantage of to track users' data. It's called the Facebook Research app, and they used root certificates to collect data on users. This could be browsing history, time spent on apps or sites, purchases made, private messages, location data, and network data, just to name a few. Now, since Facebook Research also enabled their own VPN network, this also gave them the ability to view anything that would be normally kept private under a VPN service. Now, since this is in violation of Apple's guidelines, Apple immediately revoked Facebook's enterprise certificates, which also broke some of Facebook's internal team apps, like beta versions of apps from Instagram and Messenger and the Facebook app. Those would also stop working, since those were all a part of the enterprise program. Now, after some time, Apple restored Facebook's access to the enterprise program, and your version of the social media apps, if downloaded through the App Store, are not affected, so don't worry. Now, with Facebook came similar news from Google as well. Google's ScreenWise Meter app was also available in this format that allowed them to analyze and monitor user data. Google removed their application from download and made a statement regarding the iOS app saying that it was a mistake on their part. Hey, thank you. Thank you to everyone out there who supports me on Patreon. And of course, if you are interested in getting access to a slew of extras, even if it's just $1 or $2 a month, hit that little button to become a Patreon supporter, because all of it helps. And it shows me that you appreciate the work that I put in for the show each and every week. And also a big thanks to our Hush Puppy Perk level patrons for sending in their fur baby photos. We have a couple of new ones this week. I love Four Toes and Iso. They're so cute. And yours could be up here as well if you check them out on Patreon. I love them. Keep them coming. Thank you so much. Hit that subscribe button, share this episode on your favorite social media page as well. And with that, I am Shannon Morse, and I will see you on the internet.